I'm gonna stick to like resin pinks for Valentine's Day, but I'm gonna be doing a cut crease, and I'm gonna be showing all of my hooded eyelid girls how to cut a crease when your eyelid is hooded. If you follow me on Instagram or Facebook or Snapchat, you know that I did create this video, and when I went to look at the film, my face was cut out. It was only my nose down. So and I got a lot of requests to like redo the video, so that's what we're going for today. I'm not gonna do the exact same look. I'm gonna do more so Valentine's Day, since Valentine's Day is right around the corner. Let's get right into this video. I've already done part of my eyebrows. I primed my eyes and I set them, and I've also primed my face. Oh, and I've already put highlighter under my brows, and I used the Anastasia Glow Hit. Next, what we're gonna do is start on our eyeshadow. I'm gonna go on with the Morphe 35B palette, and I'm gonna use this light pink shade as my transition. Just a fluffy brush. So for hooded eyelids, you always wanna start your colors pretty high up, because you're like, when you're gonna cut your crease, you're gonna cut your crease above your actual crease. So you wanna start those colors a little further up than you normally would, because once you're gonna cut your crease, if you start your colors down low, you're gonna like cut all the colors out. So you wanna start up pretty high, like I said. Like right under that brow bone, really. You wanna bring those colors all the way in and all the way out, because when you go to cut your crease, if you just bring the colors like right here, when you go to cut the crease, you're gonna like lose out on the color that's supposed to be in a corner. Follow me on any social media. You know that it's K-Mac from Vacation, aka Vacation. And I got sick the day I came back from vacation. I lost my voice on vacation. So if I sound a little manly, don't judge me. Next, for my crease color, I'm going to use this hot pink from the same 35B palette, and I'm going to go in with this VH Cosmetics brush. For your crease color, when you're doing a cut crease for a hooded eyelid, you always want to take it above your actual crease. So, as you can see, my real crease is like right here where this skin is folded over, but for a cut crease, I'm going to use like where my crease really would be. Like if you put a brush right here, you can feel where your eyeball is. That's why I'm gonna like make a crease. So when I actually do cut my crease, y'all gonna see why you need to start these colors high up. I know I'm saying it right now, but once I really like go ahead and do the cut crease, you'll really see. Top of the second color, just to bring this light pink back into the look. So there's no harsh lines. Now I'm gonna go in with red. This is actually a blush, but that's the cool thing about makeup. You can use whatever you want for whatever you want. By the company Black Up, I'm not really sure, but it's just a red blush. If you have a red eyeshadow, you can use a red eyeshadow. I'm gonna take this fluffy angled brush just to get into my crease better. This is by BH Cosmetics, and I'm just gonna use that red shade, like I said, and we're gonna deepen up this crease. We'll use that crease that we made, the fake crease. Second brush that we use with the hot pink color, go back in with that hot pink shade, and you want to blend out the red. Some more red. Need that red to be shopping. Deepen it up. eyeshadow just to deepen that up a little bit. It's in the 35B palette. Any black eyeshadow will work. So what I do is I take my LA Girl Pro Concealer and a flat brush from BH Cosmetics. I'm going to take some product, put it on the brush. I'm going to start at the beginning of your eye. And you always want to start low. Never start too high, because if you put too much, you can't take away. If you don't put enough, you can always add more. And that's what I like to tell myself. And the trick that I was going to show you guys kind of already just happened. Once you put a little bit of product on your eyelid and you like look up straight, or you look up to the ceiling, the product will transfer to where you want your crease to be cut. So my crease is basically like, that's where it needs to be cut. You use that as a guide and you just cut it, girl. And that is why we bring the color so high up. If I would have started any lower, the red wouldn't have been showing. To connect it at that arch, you just use like a diagonal line. Kind of the same thing with the front of your eye, that diagonal line that you connect to the arch. You just connect the diagonal line to the end of the arch as well. Voila! And when I look up, it won't transfer. So that's the trick. Like, you always want to go above that hood, because that's not your real crease. And if you do put eyeshadow in that crease, it's just in that hood crease, then it'll just disappear. Like, you won't even see it. So you want to like create a crease. While that concealer is drying, I'm gonna put a little bit more red right above my crease so that red can pop a little bit more. Eating stuff off the floor. Sick of it. What are you eating? So I'm gonna use a pink glitter, you guys. And it looks like this. And this is not cosmetic glitter, so I do not recommend using this. If you want to use glitter, you should use cosmetic glitter. But I don't. I always see people like do their eyeliner first when they're doing a glitter look. Like, they say it's easier and like the liner looks more neat because you're not going over top of it, you know, over some like clumpy glitter. So I'm actually gonna try that before I do my glitter. What I like to do is tight line my waterline, and that is to like get rid of all that white that I have underneath my eyelashes. Taking two really small brushes, one to apply the glue and the other to stick the glitter on. The eyeshadow is finished. I'm actually going to go ahead and do my foundation and everything else off camera, and I will be back with the finished look. Hey y'all, I'm back, and I'm back with the finished look. Like I said, I did do my foundation and everything off camera just because I've done it a million times on camera, so y'all already know how I do it and what I do. If you don't, I'm going to link a video in the description bar so you can see how I do my foundation and everything. I am wearing S Monroe collection lashes, y'all. 3D mink lashes. They are from my collection and they will be on sale very soon. So keep looking out for those because they are bomb as fuck. Let's be very clear.
Bomb as fuck.
Okay. For my lips, I am wearing NYX Butter Gloss. I believe it's in the color Cookie Butter. Not 100% sure, so I will have that linked in the description bar as well. I do red on my waterline just to go with my eyes. I hope y'all enjoyed this look. I hope y'all enjoyed watching this video, and I hope you learned something from watching this video. I hope you learned how to cut a crease with a hooded eyelid. That was my ultimate goal for this video. So go ahead and leave some comments down below in the comment section. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you learned something, if you didn't. Thumbs up this video. Share it with your friends, y'all. Let's make this video lit. And thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.